Arizona Science is supported by Research Corporation for Science Advancement.
For AZPM, I'm Tim Swindle, Professor Emeritus of Planetary Science at the University of Arizona, and this is Arizona Science. Joining me today is Kerri Hickenbottom, an assistant professor of chemical and environmental engineering at the university who is trying to find ways to make the treatment of wastewater more efficient. Welcome, Kerri.
Hi, thank you so much, Tim, for having me.
Kerri, we hear a lot of talk about rainfall and aquifers, but you're working on finding ways to make wastewater reusable. Do we reuse any of our wastewater in the Tucson area?
Yes, actually we do. We actually recharge some of our aquifers with our reclaimed water.
How good are the technologies that exist for purifying wastewater?
They're very good. We've come a long way with advanced water treatment. We've come so far that we even try and stray away from the term wastewater because we are looking at this water source as a resource. So we like to refer to it as reclaimed water because at the end of the day, it's the water cycle. And so we're all downstream of someone and reusing the water that has once been used for another purpose.
Can you use the same techniques on every stream of reclaimed water, or are you going to need different things in different areas?
No, you can't use the same technology and shouldn't. It's not really a one-size-fits-all type of treatment application. Depending on your end use, you really want to tailor your different sort of treatment system for the specific needs. So for example, for direct potable reuse, which is something that Arizona has been pursuing, we are looking at technologies such as reverse osmosis, followed with some additional advanced oxidation and granular activated carbon to really remove any sorts of contaminants that are in our streams and any sort of, say, taste or odor that may be in the final product waters. So it's a very, very high quality of water that we're able to produce, so high that I would even argue that it's cleaner than water that we receive from the Central Arizona Project.
What about the things that you take out of the water? Are there ways to reuse those things?
Yes, so there are ways to reuse these things, and it really depends on the type of water that you're originally given. So there are cases where you can take the concentrate that's generated from reverse osmosis. And one of the things that we can do is we can further concentrate that stream to recover additional water for beneficial use. And we can try and recover minerals. So looking at things like fertilizers or road de-icers. So depending on what constituents are in that water source, we may or may not be able to reclaim minerals for other uses.
Are those things that can be done with current water treatment plants, or do you need new technologies to do that?
These are things that we would need new technologies to be developed.
What part of the problem are you working on personally right now?
A lot of my work is looking at that concentrate stream that we're producing. Like I said, in inland regions, it can be about 30% of the total cost of these treatment facilities. So it's a really big problem, and there's lots of different solutions that we're looking at, such as, you know, using solar energy resources to drive some of our novel treatment systems that can recover more water.
Is reclaimed water having an effect right now, or do we need to do something more for it to be a significant part of the solution to the problem?
Currently, Tucson does reuse the majority of its treated wastewater, and we use this in golf courses, so mainly for irrigation. There is an amount that we directly reuse and recharge our aquifers with. And so really not a lot is going to waste. Where direct potable reuse has a really key role in this whole water portfolio is that we can directly use the treated water from our wastewater treatment facilities or the reclaimed water, treat that to a higher level so the community can use that for potable water.
Well, thank you, Kerri, and good luck with the work.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you so much.
Our guest today has been Kerri Hickenbottom, an expert on water reclamation. This is Tim Swindle, and you have been listening to Arizona Science. You can also listen to this and other Arizona Science segments by going to the AZPM website at azpm.org.
Thank you to Research Corporation for Science Advancement for their support of Arizona Science.